Monica, and I was on the Global Youth Leadership Position trip 2 years ago, and I'm a junior at Conestoga.
Hi, my name is Ankush. I'm a sophomore at Springfield High School, and I participated in the Global Youth Leadership Program last year.
Hi, my name is Neil. I'm a senior at Moravian Academy, and I participated in the Global Youth Leadership Program 2 years ago. GYLP is a wonderful opportunity for high school students to work with rural children in India.
So Ankush, Neil, and I could tell you all about our experiences, but we think it would be more meaningful if you were to hear it from a student who actually went through the Aim for Save program. So ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Serge Marigou.
Hi, Serge.
Hey.
We're so happy to have you here. I believe you live in Chatralaya for two years. Can you tell us how old you were and why it was such a positive experience?
Yep. I was 13 years old when I joined Chatralaya. I was in my eighth grade. So I've been there 2 years, and after completing my 10th, I moved out of Chatralaya. I have to stay with my mom. So.
That is really inspirational. I'm told that many of the students were very close to the warden when you were in the Chatralaya. Can you tell us what was so special about it?
Yep. So the warden was very nice person. He used to take care of all the children very well, and like he used to spend a lot of time with them, like teaching them the stuff like Bhagavad Gita slokas and like making them bath and doing all their stuff. And he used to go to the remote areas, like remote villages, find the children who need help and bring them to the Chatralaya and get them educated and good food and stuff. Yep.
That's so heartwarming. So many students who are in the Chatralaya actually have financial troubles with pursuing higher education or even going home during vacations, and the Chatralayas do help them with getting that funds. Can you talk about that?
Chatralaya was very much helpful to the students to go to their homes, and people who don't like have money, they used to give their funding to travel to their villages and come back. And some of the students used to stay during the holidays in the hostel itself to like do some activities. And always like in the morning till evening, we used to get up early in the morning at 5:30, do some yoga and get our stuff done, and then breakfast, go to school and come back. And we used to have like chant the slokas like half an hour before the dinner and go to sleep. This is what happened.
That's so incredible. Well, ladies and gentlemen, there you have it, a first-hand story of how Aim for Save is doing so much good in this world. So please give Serge a round of applause. So to continue off of Serge, when I was in the Chatralaya 2 years ago, as Serge said, the warden was very close to all the students, and I could see this so well because our warden was actually the mother of one of each student in kindergarten. And every single day, she made it a point to go to every single classroom and like teach and learn with the kids. And even during recess, she would come outside and like play with us and make sure everyone was doing okay. And it was so incredible just to see how close she was with all the students and the impact that it made.
Hi, I'm Ankush, and one of the things that I thought was really special about my experience at the Chatralaya was how we got to spend time with kids in recess time. So a lot of the times we were playing like cricket, kabaddi, like the Indian version of hopscotch, things like that with the village kids, and it was really fun because a lot of them taught us the games that I'd never even seen before, and I thought that was a really cool experience, and I would most definitely do it again.
Yeah, and for me, while we were on the GYLP trip, we got to visit a lot of the children and their houses, and I was just amazed at the community there. They didn't have much of those people there, but they were so welcoming of us into their house, and I was just so appreciative of their support while we were there, and just something I'll always remember, their kindness towards us. So, words are not everything, so we also have pictures showcasing our experience outside, so please look at them so you can see our experience.
Ladies and gentlemen, we hope we have convinced you that your generous donations are for a very worthy cause. We do have some amazing initiatives and are looking for sponsors.
Yes, and now only, Aim for Seva is actually building Chatralayas, but as well, we are seeking for sponsors to help build a second and third story for the Kripa home in Kanchipuram. So Kripa home started as a home for differently abled adults, and now it is going to accommodate adults with autism, and it provides vocational training and takes care of all of their medical needs.
So ladies and gentlemen, there are a lot of wondering initiatives that you can be a part of. If you can help in any way, do see our volunteers. Thank you.